A pleasant day to everyone. So we have here another example, applying abstract and interface. So this is the problem. Create an abstract class number that declares an abstract method print numbers, which holds two integer values as parameter. Then meanwhile, interface operation holds four methods, such as compute sum and compute difference, wherein it is a returning value methods, the compute product and compute quotient, which are void methods. The class digit will inherit class number and implement the print numbers by displaying the parameters declared. Also, implement interface operation and perform several operations such as addition, subtraction, multiplication, and division of the two numbers. And then write a Java program to test the application. So we'll start with the abstract class. But before that, we will place all of our classes, interfaces, and the Java application class in a single file. So therefore, the name of the file is our Java application class name. We'll name it public class abstract interface app. Then the main method, then we'll leave it there. Continue natin later. So we'll start with the first one, create an abstract class number. So abstract class number. And according to the requirement, it will declare an abstract method, print numbers, which holds two integer values as parameter. So our abstract class hindi na mention if public or protected. But when we say public, anyone can access the method, while for protected, only within the class and those who will inherit this abstract method. So for this one, we'll declare it as public. Then the keyword abstract. Dahil wala namang naka-indicate dito kung returning value or void method, so gamitin na lang natin yung void method. And then the method print numbers. And then, ang sabi doon, it will hold two integer values as parameter. We'll name it int a and int b. This is abstract method, therefore, there is no implementation. So, as it is. Okay, next. Interface operation. So, we'll have interface and then the name of the interface operation. Next. It has four methods, compute sum and compute difference, wherein they are returning value methods. So this is, so we'll declare it as public returning value. So there are two integer values. So therefore, our result is in integer. So int compute sum. Then, of course, we'll compute two numbers. Kaya, yung parameters natin will hold also for the two numbers. We'll name it para pare-parehas, int A and int B. Same is true. There is no implementation kaparehas ng abstract method. So, compute sum and compute difference are returning value methods. While for the compute product and compute quotient are void methods. So, ang return type dito is void. Next, the one who will do the implementation is the class digit. So class digit will inherit class number. We have it. Class digit extends number. So class to a class, so the keyword is extends. But for class inheriting the interface will have the keyword implements operation. Yung class digit ang magiging responsible na for the implementation of this abstract method and the methods declared in the interface. So let's start with print numbers. So ang gawin na lang natin, we'll just copy this one. And then we'll just remove the keyword abstract. And then since implementation, there should be a method body. So anong gagawin sa print numbers? Displaying the parameters declared. So i-display natin yung A at B. So system.out.println, the two numbers are, so i-dagdag natin yung A and plus B. Okay. Next, eto na rin, we'll copy this one. Class digit will do the implementation. That's one. That's two. That's three. And four. Take note, int, this is a returning value method. So, lagyan natin muna ng reference natin na mayroong dapat return. Okay. For void, that is there is no statement, so preferably magpe-perform ng operation and at the same time i-display na dito yung result. So we'll use system.out.println. Then balikan natin yung compute sum, will add the two numbers. So A plus B. Ang i-return natin A plus B. Then this one, ang i-return naman is difference A minus B. For product, we have A multiplied by B. And for quotient, A divided by B. So if we want to display product muna, then we'll have it product plus i-append na lang. And then, ganun rin sa quotient. So, tapos na natin. We'll just write program in the Java application class to test it. So, we'll declare an instance for class digit. So, we'll access those methods. Those methods are print numbers, compute sum, compute difference, compute product, and compute quotient. So, this time, maybe we'll accept an input from the user. We'll have it import java.util. This time we'll use scanner. So declare natin scanner scan is equal to new scanner system.in. Our inputs are two numbers. We'll declare it int x and y. And then we'll declare for our input statement. But before that, let's label it first. System.out.print. Enter first number. Then, ang magre-receive ay x. This is an integer. So, our input statement is scan.nextInt. Then, another for the second number. So, this is y. And now, let's declare for an instance to class digit. This is digit d is equal to new digit. Take note, wala tayong ginamit na constructor sa digit. So, this is empty. Then, we'll access print numbers using the object D. So, paano mangyayari makukuha yung print numbers? Of course, we have here the method print numbers. D.printNumbers. So, there, as you will notice, it has two integer values. Diyan na natin ipapasa yung x at y na manggagaling sa user. And for compute sum and compute difference and so on, so d dot compute sum, we'll have it x and y again. D dot compute difference, pasa ulit yung x and y. Because there are two integer values dito sa compute sum and so on. Compute sum, this is compute product. and this is compute quotient. Okay. Let's take a look how are we going to access it. Na-i-display na kay compute product and kay compute quotient. But for compute sum and compute difference, hindi pa because it returns the result or the output. So, compute sum and compute difference will be displayed here. So, system.out.println. So, we'll label sum and we'll just append. And same is true with compute difference. This is difference d dot compute difference. So that's it. So if we'll try to compile and run the program, first number 81, second number 9. There you go. The two numbers are 81 and 9. This is coming from the D that print numbers, this one. So, yung input na 81 received by A and B, ito yung value ng 9. So, the two numbers are 81 and 9. And then, na-compute yung sum coming from this one, accessing this compute sum. And so on. Sum, difference, product, and quotient. Okay, so that is another example on the basic programming applying abstract and interface.